always have money to have extra money, and then it helps you achieve your goals in the future. So part of your budget should be like saving money for your goals and stuff. And then it helps you avoid going into debt, and then it reduces stress, because if you have a good budget, then you know where you're spending your money and what you're spending it on, and you don't have to worry about like not having enough money to pay your bills and whatnot. So it just gives you some steps, and some of them are kind of obvious, but the ones I like the most was changing your mindset. So don't think that when you're making a budget, you just have to cut out all your extra expenses. So like I said, if you like to like read a lot, make a category in your budget for magazines and books. So you don't have to like cut out everything that you think is extra. You just have to know how much money you're going to spend on it. And then it also said that if you give yourself like treats along the way, like stuff that you like to do, put in money in your budget for things that you like to do, that it'll help you stick to it more, because you don't feel like you're limiting yourself a lot. And then it said that the number one rule in budgeting is that you can't spend money that you don't have. So you can't create a budget that says that you're going to spend a certain amount of money and you don't make that much money in a year. So it's a good concept if you use it realistically. And then just some things you should always do. Include savings in your budget so you have extra money and you don't have the stress. And then the last thing was include money for emergencies. So if you have something that you didn't plan for, that you didn't put in your budget, you have extra money and you won't worry about that. And then a question I had was that it said that to make sure you put in your budget everything that you think you're going to spend throughout the year. So don't like write things off as, oh, that was a one-time expense. But then I asked, like, if you're a college student and you're just starting to live on your own or whatever, how do you prepare?